guys, here's Madame Okay. Welcome to my channel and thank you so much for being a part of it. If you enjoy watching the videos, please, please, please don't forget to subscribe as well as to hit the like button. Thank you so much and see you soon. Bye! Here's Madame Okay, and today we will be painting daisies. So let us put my strange palettes on the side, and we will begin with a sketch. I will start with the lightest color, so I will start with my yellow. My yellow daisy needs to have a little bit of white, otherwise, when I don't use white, it won't be covering my marks of pencil. So one it's coming here, another pattern will be right next to it, so you can see it, and then I definitely can come with the yellow on the top. So there should be no problem. I can also go just around. Actually, that would be even a better idea to go around with yellow. Even in the center, it doesn't matter, because the color that we have to apply there will be the brown color. And then I can come right away with my petals. For the orange. So again, a little bit of white. I need to have white in it, because otherwise I'm afraid, okay, that the marks, pencil marks, will not disappear. So I make them a little bit bigger. I don't like when they are so small. I think it's good to have big flowers. So this one certainly will be a big one. So big petals. Coming. And I want to have a nice pink as well later on, and there will be one of them. So you see, I start changing a little bit of positioning, and I do it so that I can cover those lines and also make sure that the flower will look a little bit bigger. It will have the same shape like the other ones. So I have to put another one in this section, and I think I want to have white. So for the white, okay, even we will say there's white surface. Well, even then we still have to have paint on it. And then definitely some blue. Okay, very fast. Then I will shape it to perfection. And with this pointed brush, I want to go back to my flower and shape it. So you really shape it. So you start picking up some of this yellow, which I don't intend to have. Instead, I want to have some of the blue. I don't want to have a really powerful blue. I just need a little bit to change the color and to give the idea that it's the white flower on the white paper. So in this case, I do need to bring some other colors into it, and blue would be, I think, the most effective one, especially when you have the orange flower next to it. And I want to come with purple right away there to shape my flowers. Wow. See, like this. Orange ones. Between, even with some red, they can be darker. They don't need to be just brownish. They can have some red in them as well. And a little bit darker here, coming towards the center. Let's see, a little bit of white. And then I'm cutting beautiful orange color still has to come in the center. Those leaves, those petals still have to be better developed. And really watch them to make sure that they are well developed. And then I will place some of the purple in the center. Because I don't want them to be boring. So even the blue will be a good addition. Then some white. Will help the painting become alive. Very good. We don't want to have too much though. So for example, when this is coming on the in the daisy, the white daisy is coming on the orange, we really have to be very specific about it. So make sure that we show it. So for example, make it a little bit more bluish, the pattern. Overlapping the orange flower like this, okay, and this way you will help us to shape better those flowers. Very good. Another one will come here with a little bit stronger section. Very good. And then we have still more white coming here. What I will do now is to reshape a little bit of those flowers, and notice that I use a small brush, and with the very diluted paint I'm going back to the most prominent patterns of my flowers and repeat the shape. I add some white as well, especially though when I think that the light would hit the pattern. I want to move now to my pink. Beautiful flower, and they usually tend to round up. Also, I want to capture the essence. This could be a little bit wider here. Then we cross the edges there. And then we have to, you see the step in this part for sure. A little bit more like this. Because I really want to turn my flower. So I will make those patterns a little bit bigger, the one on the side, on the left side. And I'll make smaller the one coming on this side. So you see, but I really want to bring the notion of going a little bit like this. So I will use a little bit of the purple mixed with my color. I'm just bringing the other ones there as well. So it's not just one color. I'm showing that the petals underneath are a little bit darker, and this is because we have shadow there. I think this red is better. So just a little bit, because we certainly have some other petals. Just a little bit more. The same here. Oh, I think that's a better choice for sure. Put a little bit maybe of the blue to indicate more the center. to some of those patterns of this beautiful flower. And I need to make them a little bit brighter here and there. And I would go with it around my flower. This here. Oh yeah. Some of my blue, so helps the flower to look better, more red. And the brown that I want to have will come definitely there when we have this beautiful yellow flower. And I think we can also add it in this section. Time to work with yellow. So first we get some white mixed with yellow, and then we go for the patterns. And I don't want to have them really, really heavy, but I want to have them bigger. So one here, one there, even this one will be bigger. And then our flower will still need some extra work. White here and there. No, as long as I can mix some of those colors into the wet paint, I still will do it. Those patterns a little bit even heavier. Okay. Rounding up a little bit more. Right. And then we need another one there. And another one. Good. Whites on, and since I'm here, I'm moving to this part here as well. So I will go with some brown inside. I'm just getting a little bit darker. I can go with a little bit red because I think that will help to create this outer ring, and then the purple is a good addition here as well, but I really want to make it bigger. This very light purple I think would do a very, very good job here. So let us still go to this flower. In the meantime, we'll let it dry just a little bit so that, oh, maybe we can still work. Here and there. Very good. And then maybe more on the sides like this. Is it helping us? and stone. That actually works very well on those flowers here. I like it heavier. Yeah! So that's actually good. It's working. I still want to shape it just a tiny bit more here and there. You see, bringing some of those petals, but we do want to wrap them. The same here. We want to wrap them for sure. Getting a little bit muddy color. I don't like it. So I will have to think. No, actually that's a nice color. Sometimes muddiness is a good thing. There. Then I would go darker next to the center. A little bit. Because I think that would help to differentiate those patterns. And you still see them as white. So this would be my mother. Whoop. Button here. Maybe another one here. This is very good. I have the, do I have clean paper? Yeah, oh, good. I'm glad. So like this. Like this. Fantastic. So now we have to come with white and more emphasizing. This part, I still think that we have to go around them darker, otherwise we won't be able to see what's going on. To help ourselves a little bit, rounding them like this, just a little bit, but this will give them an idea what is going on with our. Always a good solution. See? A bit of this color and then some of the white. So the last patches here and there, making sure that you get nice stamps, that the stamps are not too thick, not too thin. As you see, bringing a little bit more life into them. I don't have a perfect brush, to be honest with you. I should have a different one, but it's too late. I went for it. Working with this brush, I have to finish my job and try to do the best. Another flower, and this definitely has to be darker, so I can here introduce some blue to really darken it, because we want to make sure that's a nice contrast between the patterns, and also those two stems are overlapping each other. So yes, I have to emphasize the difference. So you see this one for sure will be darker, and the other on the top will be lighter. Too much. And this one, let's see, I want to spread it and go just a little bit over there. That's good. Then I think I can also do the same just here. Maybe not, maybe there should be a cooler color. Let's see, because we have this very warm set of colors here, so this would be okay on this side. Fantastic! So we are done with our painting, and I hope that you enjoy the process working with me on it, and you will create your own flowers. Have a good day! Bye! that we want to do is to apply a little bit of the wash. And I think we'll be okay by going with some blue. So the blue that I want to apply will be the taillow blue, but I don't want too much of it. Just a little bit of the canvas here, better transition. So tiny bit more of this strong blue and then getting light and going up, up, up. So you see, I'm just using water that it's very dirty right now with lots of blue in it. And then I'm pushing this color around the flowers and up. Just a little bit, you see? Very, very light at the top. And doesn't need to be an even tone, remember? Absolutely not. Notice how much it helps. It does help a lot. A little bit darker on the bottom, still a little bit, because that will look so good. Fantastic! So our job is done on this painting, and I hope that you will be working on a similar painting, having lots of fun. Have a good day, bye!